SBS News.
I mean, can't even imagine.
Well, they call it the Big Island, but it's not that big. I mean,
no, it's not
small.
It's really
a big storm like that, devastation.
Yeah. I cracked open the record books over the past couple of days. Storms like this hitting Hawaii are very few and far between. So this one's going to go in the record books. Mm. It was a Category 5 3 days ago.
Wow.
And thankfully, to some sheer winds crossing at the upper levels of the atmosphere has really helped tear it apart to what we see this morning on satellite and radar. The latest on Tropical Storm Lane, the Big Island, Hawaii County getting some of that heaviest rain, especially on the eastern side of the island this morning. The center right around here. So the rain continuing to work through the rest of the island chain up through Oahu and Maui County this morning. The latest from the Central Pacific Hurricane Center, maximum sustained winds at 65 miles an hour, gusting to just above hurricane strength at 75 miles an hour, only moving to the north northwest at about 3 miles an hour. And that's going to be the problem as we go from today and into tomorrow with that slow northwestern turn to a westward turn from tonight and into tomorrow. The rain, as you can see here on Futurecast, is going to continue for the entire island chain today, tonight, and tomorrow. Some good news with it, Lane will weaken into a tropical depression by the time we hit early tomorrow morning. Only winds at about 25, 30 miles an hour, but the rain threat is going to remain, as you heard there from Chris Martinez. Over 3 feet of rain in portions of the Big Island, and we're only going to add on to this as we go from today and into tomorrow, with some places seeing another 10 to possibly 20 inches of rain, maybe another isolated area of 30 inches of rain before it's all said and done. This morning here at home, no rain yet. 70 degrees at the International Airport under that mostly cloudy sky. Dew point into the low 60s, so feeling a little more muggy as you're stepping outside this morning. Everybody into the upper 70s by mid-morning, 80s by the afternoon, with scattered showers and thunderstorms developing, although I think more dry weather is going to win today than chances for showers and thunderstorms. A few isolated showers early this morning, but we're already watching the radar over portions of Illinois and Indiana with a line of thunderstorms here that has started to take shape pretty quickly. It's thanks to that low pressure center over portions of Wisconsin and that warm front right on top of the tri-state. That's going to be the trigger for those showers and thunderstorms throughout the day today. And Futurecast does a good job with it, bringing it into our northwestern counties in southeastern Indiana roughly around noon, and then holding on to those scattered showers and thunderstorms through the afternoon and into the evening. By 8, 9 o'clock tonight, maybe a spotty thunderstorm or two when we start to break up the clouds before a few spotty thunderstorms are possible as we head through Sunday morning and into Sunday afternoon to early evening. Then once we lose those thunderstorms, we start to clear things out a little bit, and even with some sunshine tomorrow, we're going to start to warm things up. It's going to be a cool day today, but not only tomorrow, but into early next week, the heat and humidity is back. We're going to be looking at heat index values going into the mid to upper 90s as we go from Monday and into Tuesday, and even with high temperatures tomorrow into the upper 80s, what it's going to feel like when you factor in that humidity. We are looking at temperatures in the heat index department, mid to upper 90s as we go through the next 3 days. So summer's not done yet. Enjoy those cooler temperatures today. We're only heading for the low 80s by the afternoon. Scattered showers and thunderstorms pretty much the entire day today. It's not going to be a complete washout, and then maybe an isolated storm or two tomorrow, but that's when you really start to feel the humidity by Sunday afternoon, Sunday evening. Monday and Tuesday, it's going to be hot. 91 on Monday, 90 on Tuesday, before more chances for showers and thunderstorms return as we go from Wednesday into Thursday. We dry things out with temperatures still into the 80s as we go into late next week. Adam and Perry.
All right, Brian.